Hey YouTube, continuing the bus bumper project today. I'll give you a little view of what these bolts look like after drying overnight. So I'm going to wet sand these, see if I can get them cleaned up. 400. This one here I wet sanded already, so it's smoother. So we'll see. I want to try and base coat clear coat these today if I can, but that means that I can't put any more primer on them if that's the case. So we'll see. All right, these have all been sanded with 400 grit, wet sanded, and I'm getting ready to do the base coat clear coat. They were pretty good, but the 400 is just to kind of remove any orange peel that was there, you know, surface irregularities. It's a nice day, so I'm going to go ahead and do this outside. I'll mix up the paint now. So this is my base coat metallic that I'm using. And that gets mixed 2 to 1 with the reducer, so 2 parts base coat to 1 part reducer. And I only need a little teeny bit, you know, hardly anything. This metallic's really cool stuff. I don't know if you can see in the can, but you know, it's never going to mix all the way. It's always going to have some swirls to it. So I'm just going to put a little teeny bit in here. Don't need much at all. It's like plenty. Always mix more if I need it, but probably won't. Thank you. So that's pretty much ready. Get my mask on and spray it. I don't want runs, so I'm going to stop there. Let that dry for a sec.
That metallic lays out nice.
I'm just going to use up all the paint in the gun. This will be coat number 3. I don't dare do any more. There's still a lot left in there. Just about out of paint here. I'm gonna use it up. One more squirt. It. It's actually smooth. I mean, it looks like it's orange peel just because of the metallic, but it's not. All right, I cleaned out the gun with some reducer, and I'm getting ready to do the clear. This is the clear I'm using. It gets mixed 4 to 1. 4 parts of this to 1 part of this. Don't need much, just a splash really. So I'm just gonna do it right into the gun. Try and mix up enough for maybe two coats. Let's see here how this works out. Okay, spraying the clear. I don't want you to run, so I'm going to stop. Came out pretty good. I see a little grain on one of them there. So I went and got some gradient bolts for the bottom of the bumper, and I got the old brackets in here, and I'm just kind of checking the fit on stuff. This one was broken when I took this apart, and so, you know, I've got this kind of temped up in here because it needs to get tack welded and then pulled out of there and welded up good. I'm probably gonna go ahead and clean these up and paint them just so they don't rust any further. So you're looking at it backwards here. This is the right side of the bus. Yeah, this gets flipped around when it goes on. But yeah, I mean, I can see why this cracked, because these are designed to flex somewhat, the steel, and the bumper is really not designed to flex. It's aluminum, it's brittle. So I was looking at maybe a way to try and get some steel in here to reinforce this, but I'm having some issues with that. I might be able to do something with some flat bar on the bottom of it, but it's not really flat. You know, there's some twist to it because of the brackets. I guess you could say it's kind of conformed to what's going on with those things. So, but yeah, I gotta stick a tack weld on that. Maybe take it over to Buddy's house to get it MIG welded. I'm set up to weld now. I'm just gonna tack this and then take it over to Buddy's house and have him do the final welds on it. Years of Detroit diesel 40 weight and road grime coming off of this thing and rust. One down, two to go. See how crusty these ones are. Now this one's been sandblasted partially. And this is the one that was broken and had to be welded over at my buddy's house. So it's a little cleaner than the rest, so this should go pretty quick. All right, I went back all over everything with this cupped abrasive wheel. Those things really kick back butt and they leave a nice texture on everything. Just getting these things prepped for paint. Might shoot them with some primer tomorrow. Let's see. So maybe you should do a before and after on me from this morning when I was clean.
till now. 50-year-old bus part restoration. You get dirty. You gotta like it, though. It's like having a classic car and an old house rolled into one. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Stay tuned for updates. Please hit the like button or subscribe. Appreciate it.